Welcome back, everyone. So let's cover some basic questions, like core questions of Node.js. So there may be a question where interviewer can dig you down about the Node.js usability and what is the use case of using Node.js in any application development. So Node.js is actually used for real-time application where we are getting the real-time data, real-time, like real-time chat application, real-time streaming application. Whenever there is a thing about the real-time mechanism, then only this Node.js is being used much, because it handles the asynchronous behavior in better way. So Node.js application we are using for real-time chat, real-time streaming applications. We are using Node.js to create a REST API server. Okay, like this is a server-side application development, like Java, PHP, Django. So all other frameworks are also being used to create a simple HTTP API development. Same thing is being done with the Node.js, but it is adding this non-IO blocking, scalability, and event-driven features are all there, which is making it different from others. So there may be another question that when you say the Node.js is event driven, how can you justify it? So Node.js has its event driven, and it has its own library, event emitter library, where you are emitting event from source and then you are dealing with that event in the target. So event driven programming is building our application based on the response of the events. Like we will be doing a lot of different events, click, type, all these different events we will be triggering. So like simple event is add to cart, and you are passing the product ID. So you will just create a new event emitter object. And you will just pass the event name and the ID of, you can just pass the data. Then there will be a handler where we will be just capturing that. This is just a rough code, and don't go to the syntax. Event.on, and we will be just saying that okay, there is a cart.add function is triggered. And so I can capture the event object which is being passed, and from this event object you can get the data, event.productID. So there is a two different ways, event emitting, event broadcasting. So event driven programming follows mainly the publish subscribe pattern, where you can subscribe, you can publish. Okay,